After setting a lot of tiles manually, learning about rural tiles can be gigantic. Gigantic. Gigagu.
Gigantic.
Gigantic. Whatever. Just one tile, and then let the rules decide what tile exactly to draw. If you have already seen my tutorial called AutoTiling, which explains the usage of rule tiles, then you're perfectly prepared to continue. Otherwise, I recommend you to watch it before you go on with this tutorial, as I won't explain things in detail. And now, for this episode, I will show you that you can use rule tiles exactly like the default tiles. Okay, well, not exactly. There's a little bit... Yeah, okay, well... I will show you how it works, and then I will tell you that it is not perfect, and then the episode will be over. But don't worry, in the next episode we will fix this as well, and it will definitely improve your level builder a lot. A lot. I start by installing the Tilemap 2D Extras package. I use Unity 2021. In this version, this package is already released and directly available in this package manager. For older versions, check out my video where I show you how to enable preview packages. In my tiles folder, I can now create a new rule tile. Right click, create, 2D, tiles, rule tile. If you don't know how to use rule tiles, check my tutorial about this topic. But one interesting fact for you. Place the tiles that will be used the most at the top. Because for every tile, the rules get checked in this order. So of course, a center tile might be the most used one. At least in my case. I am going to create a rule tile with the tile set I use as background and in my placement restriction episode. I will place red ground, but with the according border tiles to seamlessly integrate into the grass. So, I already prepared this somehow. You can check the project linked in the description if you want to take a closer look at how my rules look like. Besides some limitations due to the tile set, it works good enough. And it just makes sense to draw this as a rectangle. What coincidence we support such a drawing method! Now, I will handle it like it is a default tile, like these here. I create a new building object base and assign it to be a floor. Per default, a floor is already drawn as rectangle, but I still set it explicitly. The first thing you will notice is that you can either assign a tile or a rule tile. It doesn't matter. But it will soon. When I start the game, yeah, well, my whole floor UI category is empty. We can see in the logs that there is some cast error. Double click at the error message and you'll jump to the position in the code. To retrieve a sprite we can show in the UI, we convert the tile base explicitly to a tile and then get a sprite. First thing, a rule tile does not have a sprite because it is not just one tile. And it is also not a tile base that can be converted to a tile. Let's command it out for now and check something. I add a log, which will log the type for every tile base. So when adding a tile, we let Unity convert it to tile base, because we are going to need this type the most. By taking a look at a log, you can see that the original type is tile, and the rule tile is a rule tile. Both derive from tile base, basically are like siblings, so we cannot convert the rule tile to a tile. Let's do the following. We will check if the type matches the type tile, then we know for sure we can explicitly cast it to a tile and have access to the sprite attribute. And for the rule tile, we will basically do the same. We check if it is of type rule tile, then we can cast it to its original type. So there is no sprite attribute, sure, but what is there? Yay, a default sprite. Sounds good, right? Let's use this as sprite for the UI. If you want to use other tiles, like animated tiles, you have to add a case for them as well. add an else statement, which will look if an unknown type has been found, and will also look its type. So it's easier for you to detect new types. We now have a preview and no error messages. You can see the main feature of the rule tile works. We can draw several different tiles with one building object. Obviously, we have one problem. The preview does not look as expected. And if you think about it, it makes sense. The preview gets drawn onto the preview map, and the other tiles we want to connect to don't exist there. The simplest solution would be to change your preview to something generic. This is what, for example, RimWorld does. Every preview basically looks the same. Sure, it makes sense there, because you will only place a draft of this item, which then needs to be built. Another option is to get rid of the preview map and to handle preview right on the real tile map. This is easy until it comes to preview rectangles, which then could get cancelled, but it can work. And it even gives the user an idea on which level something gets placed. Now, I have a preview from a floor over a wall, but we know the floor tile map is below the wall, and on drawing, the tile is hidden behind the wall. Does not seem that intuitive, huh? So, that's why I want to integrate the preview map into the map the tile should get drawn onto. We use this opportunity to clean up some code. And since some people might not be interested in rule tiles, but still want to watch the series, I decided to dedicate the next episode to it. So, let's make it short. That's it for this episode. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick and Max Vomo. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoy the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.